It appears as if Joe's got followed by a shark or by a beast. The stalactites, which are deformations hanging down, they look like the teeth of the shark. So we are down the tube right now. Look up to the ceiling, you can see pieces of steak, some plastic bottles, and stuff on the ceiling. When these water levels rise.
Or maybe 4 or 3.
Right here it's about 8 feet.
You guys, my ended,
we will be getting deeper as we go, as we keep going down.
For the purpose.
Deep as it goes, it's over 40 feet. So the name of this stage cave system, guys, is the Caves Branch Cave System. Is the second longest cave that we have in Belize. It runs for approximately 16 miles. But today, we are not doing the entirety of the cave. We're only doing about a mile. Small chamber. And this is the last part of the cave. Once you get to the point where it runs rivers, it's an open river. It doesn't, there's no other cave systems down the river. The river then joins another one. Yes, out of the 16 miles, 7 miles of the cave are cubable, where you can start and you can tube. This being the last part of it, 7 miles. I've done all. You can either tube it, you can do it on a kayak. It's an awesome thing.
What about like a canoe?
It's gonna be a bit heavy, as there are some parts where the river buries itself in the ground. So look to your kayak and go there or canyon. So you have gotta get out into the forest, and hike, and then meet the river to just comes out as well as canyon. The name of this river is the Caves Branch River as well, and the water is sprinkling. That's why it has this temperature at about 70 degrees. And it's the same temperature around the road. It never gets colder, it never gets any warmer. At any point you guys feel like the water is warming up around you, that simply means your body is warming up. The main structure of the cave system is limestone. So all of this that you guys see here is limestone. Limestone rock makes about 70% of our soil.
Limestone is actually the result of marine fossils.
Fossils of corals, mollusks, etc. are stuck together.
left button, you activate the sensor.
Deep parts of the river now. Water now is around 20 feet deep. I can say it's closer to 40 feet. Responsibility is to make all cave formations grow. The water collects very small amounts of the mineral that plants and has, and these minerals are deposited by water to the ceiling, the walls of the ground of the cave, and they once again start to accumulate, compacting once again, making the formations grow. According to geologists, the cave formations form or grow about an inch to a cubic inch every It's a slow process. Sometimes stalactites and stalagmites meet together and they form columns or pillars. Guys, look for the right button and press and hold the button. Your light is gonna go up. Press and hold. Dark. We're coming up to one of the highlights. Before there is some daylight entering. Guys, look directly towards that daylight. You will be noticing the formation which resembles a jaguar sitting on a rock looking towards you. Another highlight of the tour is coming up. It's gonna be to the left. Up here in the sea where the daylight coming. The opening that you guys are seeing there is that one of the sinkhole, or what we call it over here in Spanish, cenotes. There is another way in and another way out of this cave. And it is also the entrance for another chamber of the cave known as the Crystal Cave. Probably you guys saw a while ago there was some people going out with their cubes and they're going to go to the Crystal Cave too. That's where the water from the waterfall is coming from. Earlier today you guys went ziplining, right? The first line of the zip line that you did crosses right on top of that sinkhole. So if you were brave enough and you were looking down, you probably notice an opening to the ground. That's what you guys were looking at. Guys, not to scare you, but there's hundreds of piranhas under you.
Piranhas?
Central American piranha.
Do I lift my butt? What do I do?
I'm wondering about something sharp about my butt cheek.
Probably you did it because by this time your butts and legs are numb. But don't be afraid of the Central American piranha. The Central American piranha is not as aggressive as its relative in South America. This piranha, what it does, it nibbles or bites on your butts and legs, only feeding on your dead skin or dead cells. Minnows or tetras. There's many spots around the world where you go and put your feet in these tanks and they eat. So it's actually a spa treatment that you guys are getting.
Oh, I see one.
You see him?
Yeah, I saw it. He wasn't laughing, y'all. This wasn't a joke. I see him all.
See him ahead of you?
Yeah. Oh, it is him. That's not even that small.
I don't lie that much, guys. About 10% of what I've been saying has been truth. I'm just kidding.
You just said it so casual, I thought maybe you were joking, but you weren't.
You guys doing good? Feeling relaxed?
Yes.
Quiet and peaceful. You're all good until you met the piranhas. This cave human tours, guys, they started around the 90s, becoming very popular with cruise ships in the early 2000s. So it's not been a long time that we've been doing this. And the cave was discovered around the 1930s with some loggers and hunters. And ever since, has been knowledge of everyone around. But the first people to ever use these caves were the Mayans. And the Mayans never used the caves for cave-keeping activities like we use them today. Mayans believed that caves were the gateway to Xibalba. Xibalba is a Mayan word that describes a place of darkness or a place of fright, the underworld of what we seem to refer to as hell.
So Mayans we're in the cave of hell?
Excuse me?
We're in the cave of hell?
We're on the way to hell.
Oh.
On the way to hell.
Oh, good.
Yeah, we're not there yet.
Thanks for asking.
Nowadays, what we have heard or what we know about the Mayans is only speculations that we can talk about. We don't know exactly what the Mayans were thinking or doing in this case. Mayans as well believed that caves were abandoned temples of gods. You guys know why the Mayas thought these were abandoned temples of the gods? Mayas got a lot of gifts from these caves. The caves were a source of drinking water, a source where they could come and fish for their food. They got clay that they needed to do their pottery, to do plates, ceramics, etc. A source of transportation, the river traversing through the caves, to get from point A to point B. When the Mayas were coming in here, they were not coming with the heavy lights that we have today. They find a source, a way of doing fire, and they would bring torches, and that's what they would use to come in here. An when the Mayas came into these caves, they were not only taking stuff from these caves, they were also leaving gifts behind as a gratitude to the gods. They were leaving jewelry made of jade, the ceramics that they did over the clay. They would also bring food like corn, beans, chili peppers, etc., cacao seeds. Mayas, as well, started to do other types of activities like rituals and sacrifices in these caves. When the rituals and sacrifices were introduced, they were introduced in the late classic period of the Mayan civilization. We're talking about some 1800 years ago. During this time, the Mayas thought they were going through a curse. Probably because they were going through a drought. They were not receiving enough rains, many of the rivers and the lakes were drying out. So they thought that the gods, they had been so good with them, were angry with them. So they thought they needed, they were hungry for something else. Probably they needed the souls of good people. So when they sacrifice people, they sacrifice them the best of the best. So what do you think Maya sacrificing? Do you think this was something good or something bad with them?
Probably good.
Probably good. As imagine they were sacrificing the best of the best. So it was something good. If you were one of the best warriors that they had, these people would sacrifice you. It was something that was not like a punishment to you. It was actually like a gift they were giving. As you were sacrificed, you were given to the gods. That's when the good ones, so they immediately went up to the heavens. And they believed that when you died, either be that you got healed or you died of old age or of sickness, you would make your way to this place called Shivalta, and you would fight the evil that was in there. This was like a purgatory that you had to go through. And if you were able to conquer this place of hell, of darkness, that's when you would make it to the hands. You have to forever become trapped in this place. So being sacrificed for another man wasn't something that was bad. So we will be going down a small rapid up ahead. Bring those bottoms up. Go trapped in. You can get another side. The process of getting a bottom side can also help with the tattoo. Just before Hurricane Lisa. That was the river. River was on the other side. That was all through the rocks. And then during the pain, watch the blue, the rock goes in there. That's a blue person. So he changes. Embrace the last minutes of TV that you guys have. We're almost at the end. We'll be seeing daylight there. That's where the cave tubing comes to an end.